Hello students, myself Professor Ankur. I welcome everyone for a gate sum session on analog circuits. Today we are going to cover important sums in the topic of multistage amplifier. This is our third session on multistage amplifier problems. Let's start with the session now. Let's take the first question. This is from the GATE 2002 EC paper. The question is, the transistors Q1 and Q2 are identical with current gain beta equal to 100. Further, beta DC is equal to beta AC is equal to beta. The Zener diode DZ has a breakdown region and its dynamic resistance RZ is zero. The capacitors C1 and C2 are large and provide negligible impedance at signal frequency. So this is a circuit diagram given to us where Q1 and Q2 are identical and they are having the same DC current gain and same AC current gain, that is beta DC is equal to beta AC is equal to beta, and the value will be equal to 100. Now, the question is to identify the configuration in each of the amplifier stages. Second, we are supposed to determine the quiescent quantities of IC1 and VC1. And third, we are supposed to determine the expression for voltage gain VO by VS. Assuming VBE is going to be 0.7, small RO as infinity, and thermal voltage VT is equal to 25 millivolt. Now, if you observe the diagram carefully, for the lower transistor, the input is given to the base and the output will be taken from collector. And for the top transistor, the input is at emitter and the output is at collector. So basically it is a Darlington type configuration arrangement where we are using CE and CB configuration logic. Now, let's start with the solution. So we are supposed to find the value of IC1 and VC1. So now we can take KVL to the lower loop where RB transistor Q1 and the negative battery of -10 is present. From that, we can take the value of IB1 as VEE minus VBE by RB. So the value of VEE can be substituted as 10 and VBE as 0.7. And the value of RB will be substituted as 930 kilo ohm. Solving that, you will get the value of IB1 as 10 microampere. So IC1, which is going to be now beta times IB1, where the beta value is 100, the IC1 value comes out to be 1 milliampere. VBE2 is equal to VB2 minus VE2, which is equal to 0.7 volt. And the value of VE2 is as good as VC1 because the collector of first transistor is as good as the emitter of the second transistor. So VE2 will be equal to VC1 and the value will be equal to minus of VEE2 minus VBE2 plus VZ, which will be now minus 10 minus 0.7 plus 7. Where the value of VZ was taken as 7 volt. So automatically the value comes out to be minus 3.7 volt. This is the value of VC1. So we were supposed to find the value of IC1, which is 1 milliampere, and VC1, which is minus 3.7 volt. Now, GM can be taken as 1 by RE. RE is basically 25 millivolt by ICQ, because here the value of VT is given as 25 millivolt. So the value of RE, which is VT by ICQ, will be substituted as 25 millivolt by 1 milliampere. The value will come as 25 ohm. Now, when we talk about the Darlington configuration, CECB, the gain is going to be minus of GM RC parallel RL. So we can take 1 by 25 as the value of GM. RC value is 4 kilo ohm, RL value is also 4 kilo ohm, So RC parallel RL into GM with a minus sign. On substituting, the value comes as minus of 80. So this is the value of the voltage gain. This question is from the GATE 2003 PC paper. Let's have a look at the question. The question is, three identical amplifiers with each one having a voltage gain of 50, input resistance of 1 kilo ohm and output resistance of 250 ohm are cascaded. The open circuit voltage gain of the combined amplifier is option A, 49 dB, option B, 51 dB, option C, 98 dB, option D, 102 dB. So before we start with the solution, let's have a look at the equivalent circuitry that we'll be using for calculation. So if you observe, there are three stages of amplifier connected, where every amplifier stage is having its own internal input resistance with a value of 1 kilo ohm and output resistance with a value of 250 ohm. So now all three are now connected in the form of cascade. The voltage gain of every amplifier will be having a value of 50. So now we want to find the overall voltage gain in decibel. So we will first find the numerical value in terms of VO by VI. So VO by VI we need to calculate. So the value is going to be VO, which is going to be now VO3. So it is going to be VO3 by VI3 into VO2 by VI2 into VO1 by VI1, which is my VI. This is my product of the voltage gain that will give me the total voltage gain. Also, we are aware that VI3 is going to be as good as VO2 and VI2 is going to be as good as VO1. So we need to first find the value of VI2 and VI3. So we can take the value as AV into VI into RI divided by RO plus RI as the value of VI3. On similar lines, we can get the value of VI2 as AV VI into RI divided by RO plus RL. So eventually you are having a gain with a multiplier of RI upon RO plus RI. So that's the reason. When you find the total voltage gain, it will be 50 into 50 multiplied by 1000 by 1250 into 50 into 100 into 1000 multiplied by 1250. So that 1000 by 1250 is basically the value of RI upon RO plus RI. And 50, 50, 50 that you can see there is the value of individual gain. Since all three amplifiers are going to have a gain of 50, the substitution is for the value of 50. So on putting the values, you get the value as 80,000. So 80,000 is going to be the total voltage gain. So to convert that into dB, we need to take 20 log of 80,000. So when you take the 20 log of the value, you will get 98.06 dB. So the correct answer for this question is 98 dB. Next question. This is from the GATE 2017 ECE paper. Let's have a look at the question. The question says, in the circuitry shown, let's have a look at the circuitry. This is the circuitry. Q1 and Q2 are biased at a collector current of 2.6 milliampere. Implies both the transistors are having the same collector current. Assuming the transistor current gain are significantly large, to assume collector current equal to emitter current. So if I take collector current equal to emitter current, I can neglect the value of base current, which is very, very small. Thermal voltage of 26 millivolt. The magnitude of voltage gain VO by VS in the midband frequency range is dash up to, you need to have accuracy up to 2 decimal places. Now, if you look at the question carefully, it is clearly mentioning that both the transistors are biased for the same collector current, which is 2.6 milliampere. So with that logic, we need to keep this in mind that the collector current for both the transistors is 2.6 milli. The thermal voltage given here is 26 milli. So let's have a look at the equivalent circuitry. The equivalent circuitry shown here, you can see one transistor is NPN, the other will be PNP. So now if you observe, The top transistor, which is my Q1 transistor, is a NPN transistor, and the bottom transistor, which is a Q2 transistor, it is going to be a PNP transistor. So I've just gone for a equivalent calculation. Now, when we start with the solution, RE will be 26 millivolt by IEQ. So the value of VT is 26 millivolt and the collector current is 2.6 milli. So 26 by 2.6, you will get the RE as 10 ohm. GM is as good as 1 by RE. The value of AV is basically the value of VO by VS. So the output by input ratio will come as GM V pi into RC. So the output voltage was actually GM V pi into RC. That is the magnitude of the output voltage value. And the input voltage value, which is your VS value, will be equal to drop across the two R pi and then addition of the drops. So IB1 into R pi plus IB2 into R pi will be the total drop. Since both the transistors are biased at the same collector current level, and so we can take both the betas being the same, you will find that IB1 into R pi plus IB2 into R pi will be as good as twice of IB1 into R pi, which is as good as twice of V pi. So that's the reason the input voltage will be taken as twice of V pi. So the V pi gets cancelled and we get the value as GM into RC by 2. So on substitution, you'll get the value as minus of 50, because what we have done in the calculation, we have not considered the magnitude of the, we have not considered the sign, we have taken the magnitude, but the actual value will be having a minus sign. So that's the reason you will get the value of gain as 50. So this is the final answer. Thank you.